Hi, Spectators! You are watching HighTV, the channel of Epicness Level 42. I'm your host HighTee, and this is episode 5 of my review series, in which I will review all of the songs in this year's Eurovision Song Contest. Today we're going to take a look at the first 4 songs of the second semi-final, and it's going to be a very great episode, because overall songs are actually better this year in the second semi-final than in the first semi-final. As usual, remember that I am going to rate all songs ranging from 4 to 10, with 4 being the worst and 10 being absolutely the best. If you need more information about this episode, you can check out my first episode, which I will describe this a little bit better, or just check out the description below, where I will try to describe how this thing works. Anyway, without any further ado, let's get straight into the episode. Our first song for today comes from Latvia. It's called Here We Go, and it is brought to us by P.E.R. or Pear or Peer or whatever it's supposed to be. Please enjoy. I have to say, the song starts the second semi-final quite off well. It has a very catchy beginning, the song. It's really catchy. It like sets the mood entirely from the beginning of the song. It has a strong and really good chorus that stays in your head even after the song is finished. And I have to say that rapping in this song is actually quite funny. If we compare to some other rapping we hear in this contest, this is actually quite a nice and funny rapping. This is how rapping should be done, if you necessarily have to rap in a song. I also like the instrumental part of this song. They're all really good. Well, aside from the middle part, there are like 3 instrumental parts. 2 of them are the same, they're the good ones, but then in the middle there's that one instrumental part that doesn't fit into the song. It's a completely different style and I don't see why it's there. The other instrumental parts are maybe the best in the entire contest. I also like the lyrics, they seem quite fun, so it's not like anything too serious, which is always quite good. I think this works really well with the hectic show on stage. A lot of like crazy dancing and sound and light effects, and this would work perfectly. Most of the time the melody of this song is a little repetitive, a little bland, so it could have some little more changing stuff in there to get it more interesting. But this one does stand out in a quite positive way, and that's why it's worth an 8. Next up we have San Marino, the small little country where they speak Italian, and Crisalide, also called Vola, presented to us by Valentina Moneta. Enjoy. L'eternità vola, vola, che la forza libera sempre sola, verso un'altra libertà, la farfalla nuova lascia sempre giù, la crisalide che eri tu, vuota senza me, dalle nuvole si sa. Initially when I listened to this song, I noticed that this is a really powerful ballad, maybe one of the, if not the most powerful in the entire contest. And powerful ballads always tend to work better than the more soothing ones. I like the singer. She has a very good and strong voice. It carries on through the entire song very well. At least she used it better than last year when she was singing for San Marino. I also like that the song grows all the time. It just doesn't like grow immediately at the end. It grows all the time a little bit. And the change is also nicer towards the end to keep up the spirit. So it's a lot more like a classical type of ballad at the beginning of the song, and then towards the end, it does become a little different type of a song. And that's a little bit of the bad side of the song, because the ending is a little bit too much like classic Eurovision. I mean, it gets into really all these cliché 70s, 80s Eurovision songs towards the end of that song, and that's not that good. It reminds me a lot of a common Balkan ballad that we also have way too many of in the contest, even though this is not even a Balkan country. But it doesn't need a lot of work to, it doesn't need a big show to work well on stage. So even though it is a little bit too much esque, and even if it is a little bit too much Balkan, this is a very strong ballad, and that's why it's worth a grade of 8. Next up, we have former Yugoslavian Republic of Macedonia and Pred da se Razdeni, terribly pronounced, brought to us by Esma and Lozano. Enjoy! Uncertain about things. I mean, it has a really good male singer. I like him. That's maybe the best part of this entire song. He has a strong but very personal voice, which is good. And I think that's the only positive thing about the song, because otherwise it has a catchy beat, but it's really terrible background music. I absolutely hate the background of this song. The only really good part of this song is when the male singer sings, but the other singer, the woman, doesn't fit in it at all. They like destroy the entire mood of this song. It has really terrible and confusing bridge slash chorus part. I'm not sure if it's a bridge or if it's a chorus, but it's really terrible. It's too much Balkan for me. It could have been even more personal, not just like the regular Balkan song we always hear. It keeps way too much of the same throughout the entire song. It doesn't change at all. And the woman in this song is really, really annoying. And I really don't understand, because the parts that the man sings, those are quite nice. But then all the other parts are completely terrible. They don't fit into the song at all. So if they would leave those parts out and only have the parts where the man sings, this would be quite a nice song. But now, because of that, I can only give this song a grade, come on, a 5. Next up, we have the last song of this episode. It is Azerbaijan, the host country of last year. And the song is called Hold Me, presented to us by Farid Mamadov. Enjoy!
Seeing your smile, free falling from miles. Hold me, just unfold.
Azerbaijan does continue pretty much in the same line they have been doing for the past years, which is a little boring, but this song is still quite nice. It's a personal male voice, the singer has really, really nice voice, and it sounds very well out in the mouth, I believe. The chorus is really catchy and very nice, and the entire song has really strong lyrics, which I like. That's always a plus. Unfortunately, this song is too much of an esque cliché, so we have, like, there's a 50 of these in 20 songs. It's also the good thing, other the good things with this song is that it has really strong instrumental part. I like all the instrumental parts of these songs. It's really nice. The overall mood through the entire song is really good, which I like. It has very nice bridge part, and it works only with a basic show. It doesn't need anything really really complex to work well. So overall, even though it's a little cliche, it's a really nice, strong song, cool lyrics, and it gives and sets a really nice mood. And that's why I would give this song a grade of 8. And that, folks, is what we have for this episode. We reviewed the 5 songs, and just make sure you check out the previous episode right there, and you get to the next episode right there to see more reviews of this year's Eurovision Song Contest. But that's all I have for now, so if you enjoyed, you can join the Spectators by subscribing down below. A like is also much appreciated. If you want to, you can join my Facebook and Blogger pages by clicking on the links down below. And as usual, remember, stay strong and keep on spectating. Booyah!